up, peeps? It's Mama from Jill Mama here, and today we're playing Episode 6, A Portal to Mystery, Part 2. And as you can see, it's just Mama. Joe is out and about. So. But, if you couldn't tell in the previous video, this is Joey's favorite one, so he pretty much knows it word for word and all of the actions. So I already know what he wants me to do next, which I, as far as the one thing, so. Here we go. Now to remember how to, there we go. Let's get this. No. That would be a lot of zombies.
Shut the door! Shut the door!
Get there! Thank you! I don't know why when it comes to action and that, it's laggy.
Don't be scared!
But yet.
So we're stuck in here! And if we're stuck in here, we're all doomed!
And I can just freshly reboot everything.
I thought I heard Sparkle say something about a flint and steel.
Oh, please don't bring that up again.
Well, obviously, Talk Dog didn't steal it.
Okay, but who then? Jesse? Well, I guess I'm next then.
Nope, not happening.
But your inventory's clean, right? No flint and steel. Why would he want you? I suppose he's just being thorough. Also, I'm sure I've got something he wants.
Well, I'm sure there's a perfectly logical explanation for how the White Pumpkin is doing all this. I mean, the whole place has got to be rigged with traps, right?
You
Dog. Trap. Sparkles.
He would
trap.
Have a reason.
Yeah, we need to find out what makes these traps tick.
Adventure.
Alright, I'm gonna investigate that dining room.
Cool. I'll keep those guys in the hall for
they're
now
talking,
so I can keep an eye on
and then their mouse moves. Sorry about the lag, guys.
Excellent idea! Don't want them messing up the crime scene.
I'm sticking with you, Jesse. Doesn't seem safe to wander off alone.
Okay, people, clear out! This is a crime scene! Okay, how are you doing this, White Pumpkin?
Right.
Okay, so this was the dining table where we were all gathered together right before. Okay, let's give this a shot.
Just like before.
Greetings, adventurers. I am the White Pumpkin.
Yep.
One just like me is the treasure I desire. I will not rest until it is mine, even if I have to resort to murder.
It's just a costume on an armor stand with a jukebox for the voice. No sign of how it was triggered. Wow. The White Pumpkin must have some amazing redstone skills to rig up something like this.
Mm-hmm.
But why? Must have taken a lot of work to rig up. It must have been a diversion from whatever was going on in the room at the time. What, like you think the White Pumpkin was in the room with us? Yeah. Possibly.
Jesse!
He's back! The white pumpkin's back!
Don't worry, everyone. It's just a dummy. A white pumpkin costume on an armor stand.
Wait, what? Why?
The trap that killed Sparkles, the whole show with the white pumpkin, it was all triggered by a button on the table.
But what does that mean?
I am so creeped out right now.
Understandably.
It means that the white pumpkin sat at this very table and pushed the button.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, so you're saying that the white pumpkin is one of us?
Yep. That's right, Mr. Stampy. One of us is a murderer.
Traumatic effect.
Is that right? Yeah.
Wait, but that's not where Jesse found the button before.
There's more than one?
I'll see if I can find all of them.
Nice work, Jesse.
Yes. I must say I'm relieved to know that there's a logical explanation for what the white pumpkin's been doing.
So what now? Feels like we've made some good progress so far, though, right?
We keep looking for clues.
Once we get everyone calmed down, we need to keep looking for clues. So far, we found those tipped arrows and these traps, meaning that the white pumpkin is a great brewer and a redstone expert.
Okay, that's all of them.
If you could all please take the same seat you were at before. Four of your seats are marked. These are the seats that had a button to activate the trap. That means the white pumpkin could only be Dan, Stampy, Lizzy, or Lucas.
Wait, you're accusing us? Wait, what?
I echo their sentiments exactly. I didn't even see a button.
Me?
Hey, I'm not accusing anyone. Yet.
It sure sounds like you're accusing us, stranger. And I don't care for it.
I'm taking charge now, and I'm going to get to the bottom of this. I want everyone separated. I'm going to talk to each suspect, one by one, so I can find out who's telling the truth and who's lying. I got a whole lot of questions, and I want nice, little matching answers for each and every one of them, understand me?
Loud and clear.
Yes, crystal clear.
Who are you going to interrogate first?
Lizzy. Did want to know an awful lot about his stuff. Petra reminds me of the hired
Jesse,
help.
Listen. There's been a lot of talk thrown around today. I don't know what people have told you. I don't know what you believe. But I'll just admit it. I want that enchanted flint and steel as much as anyone.
Unless she's out.
Probably more than any of them. I've been searching
out
for
front
it for
of
years. Do you know how much it stung to have Dan, swoop in and take it from under my nose?
Oh, and so that's why you invited everyone here, huh? To find out who stole it?
I wouldn't waste my time in all these white pumpkin games. Listen, I just want to get out of here and get on with my day. What do you have to hear to be convinced that the white pumpkin isn't me?
I'm just going to be straight. Who do you think stole the flint and steel?
Well, it wasn't me, if you're curious. If I had an enchanted flint and steel, I'd be off exploring some other world with it. But me and Dan have been competing to find that thing for years. If you're looking for a likely culprit, I'd look at that guy.
I'll keep that in mind.
So, Dan or Lizzie,
You like using redstone? Ever make traps with the stuff?
I'm fine, I guess. I can make lights and doors and stuff. You want to do advanced stuff? You gotta talk to Stampy. He was the Tri-Block champion.
Tri-Block champion?
Yeah, like 2 up, 3 years in a row, if I recall correctly.
Yeah, but you're talking about Stampy. He...
Know what this is?
Tipped arrow. Kind of shoddy work, though. Definitely not one of mine, if that's what you're wondering. Some dude made that thing. Stampy asked me once about how to make those. Could be one of his. Plus, I taught Cassie and Stacy how to make those a while back.
Thanks for your time, Lizzie. That's all for now.
Stampy or Dan?
Who's up next?
Bring in the cats.
Send Stampy in here.
That's right. And bring in the cat.
Hello? That was, Lizzie on her way out, right? Listen, I don't know what she told you, but... Jesse, I'm telling you, this is just crazy! Absolutely crazy! Total misunderstanding! I don't even want that flint and steel thingy! Not as much as the others, at any rate. Did I hear someone saying that it has something to do with portals? I don't have any interest in portals. No, sir. Not for old Mr. Stampy Cat, thank you. It's me, Stampy! Everyone's friend!
Oh, come on now, Mr. Stampy. I thought you were some legendary adventurer. You want me to believe that you don't want an ancient artifact that lets you travel to different worlds?
True.
Oh, I mean, that does sound tempting, but, no, thank you. I'm fine with my local legend status. I'm a man of simple pleasures. Please, just tell me what you want to know.
What do you know about redstone? What's your skill level with the stuff?
Well, you know, about average. Average level? Moderate? I don't know how these things are graded these days.
That's funny. I heard from Lizzie that you were the Tri-Block champion.
Who? Me? Oh, what a lot. No. She must be mistaken. I know that Dan's been getting really into the stuff lately, though. Just putting that out there, in case you're curious.
Know anything about that?
Magic arrow? No, I've never seen anything like it before. Honest. Dan could probably tell you something, though. He loves weapons and all of that.
Okay, enough dancing around. Who do you think took the flint and steel?
I don't think it was ever actually stolen.
No?
Yeah, so Dan got it ahead of Lizzie, right? And she was pretty angry about it. I think he made up that story about it being stolen, so she'd think he didn't have it anymore. Classic Dan move.
You're excused, Stampy. Thank you for your time.
Oh, thank goodness. This room's making me very nervous. Not that it's any of my business, really, but... Make sure you ask Dan about that flint and steel. He's got quite the history with it.
Ready for Dan?
Yeah, yep. Send him in.
Send him in.
Hey, I don't know what the others been saying, but you have to listen. I'm telling you, you've got the wrong guy. Honest. I would never hurt anyone. You've got to believe me. If anyone's been wronged here, it's me. That enchanted flint and steel everyone's talking about, I found that. That's mine. At least it was before someone stole it. And now everything's gone completely crazy. People getting caught in horrible traps. Everyone...
Oh, I see. Someone stole your loot, and you want revenge, huh? That about the long and short of it?
Oh, no. I just want what's rightfully mine. I mean, we all want it. Doesn't mean I kill people for it, though.
Uh-huh.
I'm not the White Pumpkin. You've got to believe me. What can I tell you to convince you?
So, how do you rate your redstone knowledge?
Me? Whew, not much. Not really my scene. You want to know more about that stuff? You should ask Stampy. He was the Tribot champion.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 3 years in a row, according to Lizzie. There, you see? He's the only one here who could have built such amazing traps.
What do you know about
this? Know anything about this? Oh, wow. No, I've never seen anything like that before.
Hey, look. No, it's the Joe part of Joe Mama.
Made using potions? Nuh-uh, but you want to know about stuff with potions?
Did you do him first?
I'll ask Lizzie. She's way better with that stuff than I am.
Who did you do first, Stampy?
I always go to her potion questions.
You should have done Stampy first.
Question.
Yeah, you should have done him first. Because then he would have
killed him. You didn't say that. You said who to put in there.
To accuse?
Yes.
Yeah.
So I haven't done that yet.
Yeah, but I wanted...
I'm only questioning.
Yeah, I wanted you to question Stampy first.
Out with it. Who you stole didn't the say that.
I thought you did.
I don't know.
No,
I don't know
you were only
about
talking
it.
About accusing.
Did you expect me to believe that? Seems to me that your name's been coming up connected to that Flint and Steel a lot today.
That's because...
It wasn't.
But I wanted to ask you, do you think the white pumpkin is Lizzie?
Yes.
Yes. Yes, I do. She's always sort of scared me, and she'd have the sense of humor to come up with something as big and as crazy as this. Besides, she's obsessed with that Flint and Steel.
Shut up. Pretend like you've never watched this, and it ain't your favorite episode, and you haven't played it 50 billion times.
Oh, come on! This is nuts!
You had a button, too! Fair's fair. It's your buddy's turn next.
Hey, Jesse. Ah, my final suspect. Here to point more fingers and blame more people, I'm sure.
I didn't push the button, you know.
I figured. Thanks, though.
How's it been going in here?
He's just non-stop whispering and rumors out there.
Nepenthe and Ivor pretty much been sticking to ourselves.
So hard to say. I mean, why do they keep throwing each other on the minecart tracks? It's like they're all guilty.
Well, if there's one person who can untangle it, it's you.
Thanks, Lucas. Come on, suspect. Time to return to the others.
So, have you decided?
Yes, who do you think the white pumpkin really is?
Now hang on, everyone. First of all, I want to thank everyone for answering my questions.
There's still not 100% proof of anyone, but... Yes, where are your suspicions, Lady Jessie?
Jessie
was definitely questioning Stampy the longest.
What? No!
Dan was in there way longer.
Hey, not cool.
Guys, come on.
Having gone through all the evidence, I'm leaning towards Dan right now.
Whoa. Are you serious? Are you really serious right now?
There's just way too much drama around Dan wanting his Flint and Steel back. It's pretty suspicious.
Guys, you're not really listening to this, are you?
I say we lock him up in the library. Figure out what to do with him in the morning.
I fully endorse this plan.
Sorry, Dan, but we can't take any chances.
No, this is nuts. I'm not the white pumpkin. Are you hearing how crazy that sounds?
Well, that was certainly some excitement.
Yeah, no kidding.
If the white pumpkin is still roaming around, though, he might be trying to set up more traps. We need to figure out how these things work. Like, we know that the Sparkles trap was triggered by those buttons under the table, but what about the trap that turned Twerk Dog into a pincushion?
True.
If we figure out how these things work, we might be able to find more proof about who the White Pumpkin is, how they're operating.
Petra, I'm not sure, but the White Pumpkin didn't trigger it until Twerk Dog was in the exact right spot. That means he must have been watching from somewhere.
Creepy. Yes. Seems like it might be worth our while to poke around the kitchen.
You guys go on ahead. I'm gonna stay here, keep an eye on these other people. I don't want them trying anything when we're not looking.
Alright, well,
thanks, Lucas.
Go ahead and end the video right before you do something else.
Back in the kitchen.
Okay, if you like this video, love it.
No, let it finish playing then, right after that.
Oh.
exactly.
Okay, if you like this video, let us know. Button that like button. Comment down below. Subscribe, hit that bell, join the notification squad. And we'll see you on later. Bye.